सो गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
हाँ,
गुड आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून. गुड आफ्टरनून. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट सीपीयू सिम. आई एम गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंटिंग माय स्क्रीन फर्स्ट. ओके, इट्स अ प्रेजेंटेशन. लेट मी नो व्हेन माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू.
It's feasible.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so what is CPU SIM? CPU SIM is basically a freeware. Okay, it is an acronym for CPU simulator. Okay, so we are going to look at this software for our CSA practical lab. It is basically a Java application. The CPU SIM itself is basically an application written in Java, in the programming language Java, that allows the users to design simple CPUs, okay, and also to write assembly language programs or machine language programs. Okay, you remember I talked about the different types of languages that are there. There are high level languages, for example, C++ that you are learning right now, Java is yet another. And then there are low level languages. Low level languages are closer to the system hardware, I had told you. And therefore, you know, they work with direct binary numbers sometimes, as is the case with the machine language programming language. And then from machine language programming language, we evolved onto assembly language programming language, which is another kind of low level language, in which we replaced some binary codes with some mnemonics. Okay, so what are mnemonics? Mnemonics are names which are easier to memorize, or names that are familiar to us, which we use more often. As we have discussed time and again, it is very cumbersome to use binary codes for writing a program, for debugging a program, right? Even for understanding a program, right? So if we users have to, you know, write the entire programs in binary, as was the case in the machine language programming language, then it became very difficult for us. Okay, just give me a second, please. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. So in the machine language, we always had to code in binary language. Okay. Only the programs had to be written, everything had to be written in binary. Okay. So if we had to add two numbers in assembly language, we could use a mnemonic. For instance, I could have written add x comma y, okay, which would mean that I am using a mnemonic add for the operation code, and x and y to be the names of some addresses. For instance, you are already familiar with the variable names in the high level language programming languages, so x and y serve as the variable names, right? So all these are what these are mnemonics. or the words which are easier to use, which are easier to memorize, right? So at least this much flexibility assembly language program languages granted us. But machine language programs we had to give binary code for the complete opcode, as well as for the we had to code the actual addresses, right? So we will see how to write simplistic assembly language programs on CPU sim as well. This was a recap of the languages that I did with you. I have already talked about this in one of my lectures earlier. So the idea is that since here in the CPU sim, we are going to be looking at directly configuring the CPU with our own hands. So we will be using a low level language, not the machine level language, but assembly level programs. We will be some simplistic assembly language programs you would be writing, okay? And one of the flexibilities that a CPU sim offers is that it can be used to simulate the CPUs for a variety of computer architectures, okay? Many architectures, CPUs for many architectures we can do, okay? Yeah, can somebody help me read the screen? Who would volunteer today?
Ma'am, can I?
Yes, who's this?
Ma'am, Chayanika.
Yeah, Chayanika, please.
CPU sim is a software development environment for the simulation of simple computers. It was developed by Dale Skrien to help students understand computer architectures. With this application, the user is able to simulate new or existing simple CPUs.
Okay, is this clear? So what is a simulation software? Basically, what is simulation? So simulation basically means that you kind of get a look and feel of how the actual thing works. Okay, so it is a kind of software that gives you that look and feel of the actual environment. So you feel that, you know, you are actually doing something that would be done in the actual application, right? So this is just to help you realize the concepts of the register set that we have seen, the memory. So you'll see that using the software, you will be able to put all these things together. The registers that we've talked about so far, the memory, that is the RAM, okay? And the, so these are the two types of memories, right? That we have talked about, one inside the CPU and other just outside the CPU, with which the CPU directly works, right? And then we are also going to design our own instruction set now. Okay, so you have already read about, we've already done the different types of instructions. And in each kind of instruction now, you will see many actual instructions I will do with you. And how are these instructions implemented? I'll teach you. And then you will design your own instruction set in CPU sim, just akin to the one which is given in the textbook. Okay, so you will make all those instruction sets. You will, you know, you will implement all those instructions yourselves on CPU sim. Is this clear? So that is a kind of environment that this software is going to give us. Okay, so we must acknowledge Dale Skrien, who developed this software, okay, and gave it to the universities worldwide to experiment, okay, so that students world over could understand the concept of you know, designing their own instruction sets and what is actually meant by designing a basic central processing unit. Okay, so what are the aspects therein? Yeah, Chainika.
Yes, ma'am. Users can create new virtual CPUs with custom machine language instructions, which are implemented by a sequence of micro instructions. CPU SIM allows the user to edit and run assembly language programs for the CPU being simulated.
So this is what I have already told you. You may find a term here which is called micro instruction. So I will be doing this with you in subsequent classes, where I'd be discussing in detail what is a micro instruction and what is a machine instruction. Okay, so I will be discussing that with you, and then we'll see how to develop ALP, that is the assembly language programs, using the machine instructions, which are in turn developed by using micro instructions. Yeah. So this slide shows you certain features of the CPU SIM software. Yeah. Can you please read, Chanika?
Yes, ma'am.
This is just for your information.
The newest version 4 of CPU SIM is written using the Java FX package. Version 3, which is still available, was written using the Swing package. Version 4 of CPU SIM should run on any platform that has the Java Runtime Environment, JRE, version 1.8.0U66, or a later version of Java 1.8 installed on it, but not Java 9 or Java 10. Version 3 of CPU SIM should run on any platform that has JRE version 1.5 or later installed on it. Version 4 is backwards compatible with version 3, in that all machines created in version 3 can be loaded and run in version 4.
Okay, so see, we are going to use CPU SIM version 3.9.0. Okay, that because that is what is mentioned in our guidelines, but a latest version is available now. I'll just show you. So this is a simple comparison. So although we will be working on 3.9.0, there is not much difference actually in what we are going to do. So we will stick to the version that is listed in your guidelines. Okay, but I just wanted you to have a know-how of what is now new in version 4. So basically, since CPU SIM is a Java application, we need a JRE or Java Runtime Environment, as it is known, to run it. So a prerequisite for installing CPU SIM would be that you would need to have Java in your JRE in your system. Okay, so we will talk about this. I'll just show you how to install CPU SIM, and then I'll talk about this. Okay, the respective versions on which the version 4 and version 3 run are written. Okay, yeah.
CPU SIM has the following features: allows the creation of a CPU, a virtual one, including the registers, RAM, micro instructions, and machine instructions. Allows the creation, editing, and execution of assembly language programs for the simulated CPU. Allows stepping forward and backward through the execution of assembly language programs.
So this is what I have already told you. I've already discussed this with you. So we will see this in our gradual practical classes now. Okay. Yeah. CPU SIM installation.
First, download the CPU SIM zip file onto your hard disk. Second, unzip the CPU SIM 4.0.11 zip file.
Whichever version we are. installing, we need to use the zip file of that particular version. Okay, so let's call it CPU sim XXX file. Okay, yeah.
The unzipping process will create a folder called CPU sim XXX containing.
So whatever is the version will replace this. Mm-hmm.
Containing 10 documents and a folder. Third, install Java 1.8.066 or later on your machine if it is not already there. Go to the website as given here to get the software and to read installation instructions. Fix, if necessary, your path system variable so that it includes the bin directory installed as part of the Java installation in which the Java interpreter application is located.
Okay, right. So let us see how to install CPU sim next. Is my screen visible to everybody? Is my system visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, right. So what we are going to do is, for CPU sim installation, we simply go and type CPU sim on Google search, right? The first link that it generally gives is the home page. You can look at this homepage otherwise. This is www.cs.colby.edu. Okay. And here you'll find a lot of information about CPU sim. And then there is a download section here, right? So whichever version you want to install, you click on the corresponding link. We will be downloading CPU sim version 3.9.0, right? So as soon as you do this, please see that a zip file with the name CPU sim 3.9.0 is downloaded. Okay, so I'll go to my downloads section, and this is what you see, right? So you can see the zipped file here. So let us extract this. Let us extract the contents of this zip file. So since I already have CPU sim, I'm going to change the name of the directory. You can leave this. You don't need to do this, right? So I say extract. This is what I get. Okay. So this is a file folder for Mac system. So somebody was asking me that day, will CPU sim work on Mac? Yes. Okay. And this is for CPU sim 9.0, but you will have to possibly see the instructions. This link of the website I'll send to you, okay? And there may be a little different installation instructions there for Mac so that you can see. Now here, there is a bat file, okay? This is a bat file, okay? What is a bat file? It is a actually .bat is the extension of the batch files. Okay, so once we click this, this is cpusim.bat. Okay, you can see Windows batch file listed here, right? As soon as I click this, double click this, I get a terminal, okay? And then cpusim opens, right? If in any case this interface does not open on its own, then what you can do is you can simply press a enter here. Okay, sometimes you need to press a enter here, and then the graphical user interface of CPU sim would open, right? But as I told you, this would require successful installation of CPU sim would require that you have Java in your system. So how do you check whether you have Java in your system or not? For that, you can go to the start menu, right, and open a terminal from here. So you simply write cmd, it will give you a command prompt. Okay, and here I can simply check if I have Java installed, and in fact also the version that I have installed by giving this command java slash version dash hyphen version, right? It shows me Java version 1.8.0.261. So this is this version is already installed on my system, right? So if you don't have Java installed on your system, then you will have to first install Java. Now, from where can you install Java? Let me tell you. So before downloading CPU sim, you check for Java and you go to this website. Okay, again, either you can have this link or you can simply again get to it through a search engine, for example, like Google, and you can say Java download for whatever Windows or Mac or whatever you have, right? So mine is Windows 10. So I'll say this, and then this is the link that I'm going to open. Okay. Here you can see the installation softwares and also the instructions for installation of Java. Okay, so first install Java and then install CPU sim, right? Okay. Let me now introduce you to the GUI of CPU sim. Please let me know when my screen is visible to you. Is my screen visible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, right. So this is the basic graphical user interface for CPU sim. This is the first screen that opens up. By default, the CPU
Excuse me,
sim.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I think you're presenting the wrong screen because we can just see your downloads folder right now. We cannot see the CPU sim GUI.
Okay, I'll represent. Thank you for your input, Gute. Is CPU sim visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So as you can see, the default view has three windows. The first one is a text editor where we can write assembly language programs and machine language programs. The second one is a window that shows me all the registers that are there in my machine. And the third one is the snapshot of RAM, that is the working memory that my machine has, that the machine that I am going to create using the CPU sim has. As you can see, a sample machine which has already been created called Wombat is already loaded when you start CPU sim. So these registers and this memory snapshot that you're looking at are all a part of this machine. Okay. This machine is very helpful. You can, you know, back and forth, keep on referring to this machine whenever you get stuck somewhere. Okay. But for the time being, I'm just going to close this machine and let us just open our new machine. So how to open a new machine using CPU sim? In the file menu, go to this option, new machine. Now you can see the name new here. Okay. Now, please see in this view menu, when I go, I see only one option that is given to me, which is registers. Okay. And then it says no register array and no RAM. Because in my new machine, there are no registers that I have created so far, and there is no main memory. Okay, so let us start creating our registers as we had done in our class using the representation, using the basic registers that were given in our textbook. Okay, so how to create a register? You can see that up till now, there is no register here. Okay, the window has opened, but actually it shows no registers because there are no registers so far that I have created, right? So to create new registers, I will go to the modify menu, hardware modules, and then in the type of module, I will select register. Okay. And say new, right? Let us first make program counter. Okay. So the first register that I'm going to make is program counter. And what was the width of program counter, if you remember?
12 bit.
12 bits, right. So we are, for the time being, we are going to stick to the same configuration that was mentioned in the Morris manual. Then let me make the other register for the addresses that we called AR, or the address register, right? And what was the width of the address register?
12.
Right. Let me also make AC, that is the accumulator. And what was the width of accumulator?
16.
16.
Right. So similarly, you can make up all other registers, okay, as per the configuration which we had discussed in the class, right? And now you can see that the registers that you've just made are reflected. Okay. Now let us make our own RAM. Okay. So again, I go to modify menu, hardware modules, and I select RAM, right? And I say new. Let me name my RAM as RAM 1, okay, for the time being. Now, how many addresses you want to be there in this RAM that you have to give here? So I think the configuration that we used was 4096. And what was the word length? It was 16, right?
16.
So that is what I'm making right now. So let me show you. I am done, right? Now, from the view menu, please see that you find that your RAM with this name RAM 1 appears. Let me click on this and you can see a window for this. Okay. So in this RAM, these are the addresses. Okay. So please see the address starts from 0 and goes up till 4095. Okay. And there will be 16 bits of data that I will be able to store at each location. Okay, now in what format this data is displayed? For example, let me show you. Suppose I write down 10. Okay, so data right now is being depicted in the decimal number system. Okay, now let me turn it to binary. You can see that how many bits are there? 16,
16.
Right?
Right?
And what is the value? The value is 0, 0, 0, 10. Okay, so the value remains the same, only the depiction, representation is shown to you in the number system that you so desire. Let me, look at it in hex. Then this will become what? 0, 0, 0, 8. Right? Okay. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Similarly, the addresses obviously cannot be altered, but you can view them in binary as well as in hex. Okay. So whatever you feel comfortable in. Right? Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is just a representation. We can look at the data in whatever way we wish to look at it. Okay. And in this window, registers, again, you can see that what we have is the name of the register. It shows us the width, and it also shows us the value stored in these registers. So when we start writing our own assembly language programs, okay, you will see how we will assign values to these registers and how we will be able to look at those values from here. Is this okay? Right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
another ma'am. Part yes, ma'am. Of another part of CPU sim interface is this window, which is called IO console, and this can be used to give some commands to the CPU sim. So which commands, how to give, that I'll discuss with you later, right, in the next class. So today we have seen what is CPU SIM, how to install it, and what is the basic GUI or the graphical user interface of CPU SIM. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.